Here's the neck of a 65-year-old man. As you can see, this is a case of extremely thick and coarse hair, and this is unusual for neck hair. This was a difficult case for me. The hairs were not easy to see, and the amount of hair presented several challenges. The client is a redhead and has Fitzpatrick type 1 skin, indeed, very white skin. The fellow is a geologist and spent many years outdoors in the sun. His skin is dry and leathery. With such skin, you will find the follicle openings somewhat inflexible. With white hairs like this, the follicles are often deep and the roots large. Because the follicle openings are snug, sometimes the sheaths invert or are sheared off as the hairs are removed. Because of this, the sheaths form clumps in the epidermis. Notice the little clusters of tissue that form with most of the epilated hairs. The clumps look sort of nasty, but they're not significant and not an indication of overtreatment. The cross-lighting, of course, casts shadows and makes these little clumps more evident. When sheath material is stuck in the follicle, pustules usually form as the body rids itself of the dead tissue. I assumed the patient would develop pustules, but he didn't. The patient said he showers 2 times a day. So in this way, the material was simply washed away. Additionally, post-treatment scabs didn't form either. The patient put nothing on his skin and only showered with soap and water.